Stephen Sivley. I'm a worship pastor at Shades Mountain Community Church, and this is my week to share some thoughts on worship ministry. And I wanted to share a quote from Bob Coughlin from the book Worship Matters. And Bob describes worship leadership in this way. He says, a faithful worship leader magnifies the greatness of God and Jesus Christ through the power of the Holy Spirit by skillfully combining God's word with music, thereby motivating the gathered church to proclaim the gospel, to cherish God's presence, and to live for God's glory. And that's such an incredible quote. He puts it in words that I never could. And that's basically the goal of our worship ministry. We want to honor God. We want to magnify Him using God's word and thereby empowering the church to worship Him and to live for Him. So that's, in a nutshell, a lot of what we're trying to do as a worship ministry. And I wanted to talk a little bit, one component of what we do as a worship ministry, and that is giving God glory. In Isaiah chapter 6, verses 1 through 5, we see an incredible picture of worship in heaven and what that looks like. And Isaiah saw a vision of God's throne room, and he saw living creatures worshiping. And in verse 3, it says, they called to one another and said, holy, holy, holy is the Lord of hosts. The whole earth is full of His glory. And Isaiah's response to that, when he saw God's holiness and when he saw the living creatures worshiping God, his response was in verse 6, woe is me, for I am lost, for I am a man of unclean lips, and I dwell in the midst of a people of unclean lips, for my eyes have seen the King, the Lord of hosts. And so when we try to, in congregational worship, we want to honor God, we want to bring Him glory. And we see the result of this in Isaiah's life and the vision that he saw. He came to a point of repentance. He saw God's holiness and he recognized his separation from God. And so our desire is to bring God glory through our worship. We want to honor Him. We want to sing scripture. We want to sing truth about God and count on the Holy Spirit to work in people's lives, to bring people to conviction, to bring them to repentance and to a right relationship with Him. And so we're always seeking ways to glorify God in our musical worship, in our congregational worship time. And then another passage of scripture that I always look to is Revelation chapter 4. This is another scene in heaven that John sees. It's a very similar situation, and he describes the living creatures. And in verse 8 of Revelation chapter 4, it says, the four living creatures, day and night, they never cease to say, holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty, who was and is to come. So literally right now in this moment, this is happening in heaven. This is a continual thing. They never cease to say, holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty. And so we join with them when we worship. Psalm 19 talks about the heavens declare the glory of God, and the skies proclaim His handiwork. We are joining with creation. We are joining with heaven when we worship God. It's an incredible privilege that we have to glorify Him as His children, as we worship our Father, as we honor Him. And finally, in Galatians chapter 6, verse 14, Paul says, be it far from me to boast, except in the cross of our Lord Jesus Christ, by which the world has been crucified to me, and I to the world. And so in our congregational worship, we want to do everything we can to honor God. We place less importance on men's preferences, but we want to please our God so that at the end of each worship service, it's not necessarily, what did you think about the worship service, or what did I think about the worship service, but what did God think about it? Was He honored? Was He pleased? Did we worship Him in spirit and in truth? And so God's glory is always on the forefront of our minds as we lead, as worship leaders, and as a worship team. And so we encourage you to think about God's glory as you come into worship on a Sunday morning, and look for the ways that you can honor God and glorify Him through your worship. And just know that we as a worship team, we are always praying for God's wisdom in our lives and in our ministry, that we would glorify Him, that we would bring Him great glory and great praise and great honor, and that He would be pleased with what we do. Thank you guys. Have a great day. We'll see you Sunday.